Hi, I'm Dr. Perkins, and today we're going to talk about microbiology. So, what is microbiology? Well, microbiology is the study of microorganisms, and these are organisms that can only be seen with the microscope. And so the term micro means microscopic. Well, biology is the study of life, and therefore microbiology is the study of microscopic life. It also includes the study of viruses, though, which are not living at all, and we'll get into that later. But most people studying microbiology are interested in how microorganisms affect the human body. So we often talk about diseases caused by microorganisms, even though most microorganisms don't actually cause disease. In fact, most microorganisms are actually beneficial to humans, such as Penicillium roqueforti, the penicillium mold that is used to make blue cheese. Yes, one of my favorite things to eat is actually a mold. And microorganisms such as Alcanivorax borkumensis are beneficial to humans because they derive energy from oil, so they've been used to clean up oil spills. And many microorganisms cause what are known as biofilms. These are slimy layers, such as the one seen in this microscopic view of Staphylococcus aureus, which is a biofilm from a catheter. Microorganisms are known to cause infectious diseases, such as COVID-19, which is also highly contagious. Infectious diseases are those that happen when a pathogen or disease-causing agent invades a host and carries out at least part of its life cycle inside the host. There are many different types of microorganisms, and scientists like to classify things into categories based on similarities among those microorganisms. In fact, this is a good part of what the subject of microbiology is. What are those categories, and how are the organisms in those categories similar to or different from one another? We have 7 different categories. First one is the bacteria, such as E. coli, the bacteria that is a natural resident of the human gut. A bacterium is a single-celled organism that lacks membrane-bound organelles. There are also the archaea. Many of these are known as extremophiles, meaning they live in extreme environments, such as this halobacterium, which is known to live in the Dead Sea under extremely high salt conditions. The archaea, like bacteria, are also single-celled organisms that lack membrane-bound organelles, but they're very similar to eukaryotes in many of their nucleic acid sequences. Then we have the fungi, such as Aspergillus fumigatus. This one is known to cause infections in the human lung, especially in individuals who have weakened immune systems. Then we have the protozoa. Protozoa are single-celled eukaryotes, such as this Plasmodium. A eukaryote is an organism that has membrane-bound organelles. Humans have eukaryotic cells, but the protozoa are the single-celled eukaryotes. Plasmodium is known to cause the disease malaria, which the World Health Organization in 2018 estimated that 405,000 people worldwide died of malaria, and 2/3 of those were in children under the age of 5. Malaria is known to be transmitted by the mosquito. This is a picture of a mosquito containing Plasmodium that is estimated to be about 15 to 20 million years old. This is a fossilized mosquito embedded in amber. Another category of microorganisms are the microscopic algae, such as this Nanochloropsis. Microscopic algae are photosynthetic. They are single cells. They live in communities, or they can gather together in long chains. They are not known to cause human disease, but many species give off a toxin that can be harmful to humans. This is a eukaryotic photosynthetic cell. And they have the helminthes, or the parasitic worms, which is the category of microorganisms that I find to be most disgusting. This is a picture of the tapeworm, Taenia solium. Taenia solium can be 2 to 3 millimeters long, so that's pretty small, but can also grow up to 8 meters. Finally, we have the viruses, which, as we mentioned, are not known to be living. This is a picture of the coronavirus. The term corona means crown, and this particular group of viruses was named because the outer protein spikes, shown here in red, looked like a crown. Viruses, we mentioned, are not actually living because they cannot survive independently of a host. They also have no way of acquiring food and using it for energy, but they're more than capable of wreaking havoc on our health. For example, this pandemic that is caused by SARS-CoV-2 virus, a type of coronavirus, which causes COVID-19. There are thousands of other viruses, and they infect every species on the planet, including bacteria. And thank you for listening.